Good evening, everyone. Today, I want to talk to you about... Today, I want to talk to you about this little piece of software that I wrote for myself a few months ago while I was writing a project proposal for the European Commission. So, this is a little bit of time. First of all, I'm going to give a brief overview about the typical project structure, since I guess that not everyone here wrote project proposals. Then, in this way, I will be able to describe the problem that I wanted to solve. And we'll talk a bit about the code, about the plugin structure that I guess it's a cool feature of this program. And then work in progress, what I'm doing right now. So you have your project. You have people working it. And the work in the project is split into work packages. You could have, for example, hardware design, software design, communication, management, stuff like that. Inside every work package, you have tasks. So, for example, hardware development can have hardware design, prototype development, industrialization. And the tasks makes deliverable that are stuff that you can share, you can show to someone else. It can be a prototype, a document, a website, a video. And while the project evolves, it reaches some milestones that are moments in time when you say, okay, so far so good, now what? For example, you can have work package hardware development. Inside that, the task, the prototype development, gives you a deliverable, a prototype. And when you have a prototype, you say, okay, we have a prototype, now what we do? Okay? This is more or less the basic structure. So you have your idea for a research project you want to be funded. You need to describe it to the European Commission in order to get your funding. And how do you do that? Well, there is a format that's more or less standard. If you wrote a research proposal, you know that. You have work package cards with the name work package, the effort of every partner, when you start, when you end, what you're going to do, and the tasks with start and date, and so on, so on, and deliverable, and so on. Besides the work package cards, you are also asked to produce some summaries, such as, for example, the list of deliverables, the list of milestones, and in the case of European project, a summary of the effort by work package, by partners, and so on, so on. And last but not least, a graphical description of your project. What is the problem here? This makes sense, okay? We can agree. What is the problem? The problem is that this description is reasonable as maybe, it's redundant. There is lots of cross-linking, cross-references. And if you change something, you have a tsunami of change to do. For example, suppose you add 3 months to task 1.3. Then work package 1 needs to last 3 months more. A work package 2 and 3 that starts when work package 1 ends needed to start later, and the task inside them needs to start later, and the deliverable will get later, and the milestone will change, and the effort will change. And you need to change everything here, here. Maybe the milestone will also change order, because if one milestone gets later, maybe a new one gets the first. So it's a mess. Okay. Honestly, I don't like you just need to pay a little bit of attention. I don't want to pay attention. I have the deadline that's creeping day after day, closer and closer and closer. I have a page limit of 15 pages that's way too short. I don't want to pay attention. I want a software that pays attention for me. That's why I love coding in Ada. The compiler pays attention for me. So I wrote this piece of software. You can imagine how much I hate this stuff since I wrote a software for just doing one project. And this is the internal structure of the code. It's very simple. You have a parser that takes the project in a simple format, not redundant, brings it into an internal format. That's handled by this block, more about this later, and the result is given to processors that do something. In my case, generates some files that include in the project. The nice part here is that parser and processor are not fixed, but are implemented as plugins. What that means? It means that I have, inside the code, an abstract parser that's in an interface. For those of you that are not familiar with this part of ADA, is more or less an abstract class, roughly. If you want a new parser, you derive from this interface, provide a constructor, function create, and a function parse. That's it. Then you register your new parser with this function. The user, when calls the program, specify the parser to be used inside the command line. At the moment, there is only one parser. That parse, this is a format here. I'm not going into details, it's very simple. I want just to point out two stuff. First, the date here, for example, is not a number, it's an expression. This allows you to specify, for example, that one task needs to start when another task ends, in a very simple way. And the nice part is that replacing this with an actual number is not done by the parser, but by the housekeeping block here. So this means that if you write a new parser, you have this feature for free. And the other part I wanted to show you, that's more or less an anecdote, but it's worth saying. You see here the deliverable. And the date, it has three dates. 12 months, one year, 2 years, 3 years. That's reasonable because sometimes, in this case, for example, is a report. During the project, you have few reports during the project. So it makes sense to have some kind of periodic deliverable. At the beginning, I didn't take care about this. And the deliverable just had one date. Okay? And this was a design decision that was quite deeply inserted into the code because it was part and in sense of the model of the project that I had in mind. Then, while writing the project, it came out that there are also periodic deliverables. I had to change this, and this require quite a deep change in the code, because as I told you, it was part of the model that I used to do the code. Time to do the change, half a day. I was impressed. I don't want to do that. I don't know. No, it's tomorrow. It's half a day. After, at the end, it compiles, it runs, and it works. That's what I love about Ada. And here, processor plugin. This is the output. I'm not going to details. It's the same stuff as before. And there are, at the moment, two plugins for the output. One is dump, as you can imagine, is for debugging purposes. The other produces a lot of LaTeX files. And the high-level aesthetic is coded inside the other code. The most of the aesthetics is coded as LaTeX macros. But the high-level structure is inside the other, and that is not good. I mean, as long as I was the only user, that's fine, no problem. If I want to make it available to other people, sure. So I want to introduce this template-based approach, and but this is still a work in progress. Just let you know that the LaTeX plugin is what produces this, this is actually a LaTeX feature, was automatically produced from this, not from this. And let me tell you, it saved me lots of work, lots. Also including the work done to write this. So the new template output processor will be template based. This is just a taste of the syntax. Very PHP-like as a philosophy, but the language of the template, I guess you feel at home, okay? So, work in progress. More documentation. Actually, it's not so bad. Yes, I want to add markdown inside the content. Let's go back here. Here you see the work package. This is kind of a tribute of the work package. And this is the content. As you can see, this is LaTeX. I want to move to markdown in order to allow for different output format, of course. And okay, and the template-based processor. Okay, so this is the almost last slide. Some pointer to the project, to myself. And no. What are you doing? Annule. Okay. Okay, and that's all.
Have you envisaged to submit a project to the European Union to propose them a project generation?
No, not really, honestly. This is something that mostly I wrote first for myself. You know, the open source stuff starts from when you try to scratch your itch. I published on GitHub. I guess that maybe someone else could be used for that. That's it. I guess it's an application and also a very niche application. Okay, it's not just I don't know an editor. That's why this. If you ever wrote a European project, you know that this can save you, at least at me, saved me a lot of work. To be honest.
Well, maybe not much of a question, more of an observation. The EU proposal workflow must be really painful if you actually decide to write that whole stuff. On the other hand, you know, there's MS Project, which kind of does something similar, so I think there might actually be more, it might be less of a niche market than you think if you're talking outside of EU proposals. You know, projects are delivered, you know, project plans are delivered to all kind of managers all the time.
Yeah.
And, you know, they all have the same dependencies in issues.
So the observation was that maybe if it's outside of European proposal, it's maybe less than an issue. Maybe.
Niche, I mean.
Yeah.
Because you said niche market. So, yeah, it looks at the first glance. But on the other hand, there's MS Project and they make big money with it.
You know, I come from the university, so I'm used to write project for research proposals. And this is for European Union, but also for Italian proposals. It's more or less the same. And, I mean, you can do it, okay? And let's be honest, it was also fun to write the code. So that was a part of the motivation. And it was much more fun writing the code than trying to...
The side effect of the code, it doesn't work for you.
Yeah.
And you have fun doing it. So,
yeah, but I know, I guess that maybe the same could be useful for someone else, at least in the university. You see, there is another fact that it produces LaTeX code, and usually European proposals are written in Word. Anyway, maybe you could write, someone else could write a processor for open document, so you can get open document format that you include inside in the different proposal. I mean, this, of course, is, by the way, this also is quite young. I submitted the project on September of last year. So this is very, very, very young. Of course, it's suited to myself because I wrote trying to scratch a problem of mine. But if there is input from someone else and can be useful to someone else, I will be happy.
And you can integrate the dependencies between the task and when you write that.
Yes. Yes, there is
sometimes it's not automatic. You said
yes.
That some milestones.
Yes, as
before, but sometimes you have sometimes to change a little bit because there are some components for which that you need for.
No, if you
being able to start the task and then.
Yes, so the question is if it's possible to integrate the dependence for task. Yes, it's almost automatic in this case with the date expression. So you say. This task begins when this one ends. There is not yet, I planned to do, then I discovered that the date was enough, a formal dependencies. So this task depends on that one. There is not, but if you look into the code, you see that there is some kind of placeholder to put this kind of stuff. And that, in my opinion, that's it was the most useful part, because otherwise my experience in European project is that you are at a point and you say, okay, freeze it, don't change anything, don't ever think about changing, because in this case I could change anything at the very last day.
Okay.
Thank you. You're welcome.